Can you believe that it's June 29th already? That's tremendous, tremendous, because I've said June 30th, we're likely to begin to feel a boost taking place for us. So welcome to the video. I'm going to start out with something very, very important, crucial. And that is that our question is the mind inherently a liar? And if such, we can't trust it. Now the mind will claim that it's a liar. And then we'll say, mind, you're lying. When you say that you're nothing but a liar, you're lying. But then the mind will say, well, that just proves I'm a complete liar, right? See, the mind wants to convince us that it's a total liar, so that we can't trust it, so that we have to continue on distrusting reality, so that we don't drop this desire to be prime creator. So either the mind is a complete liar or it's not. And yet the mind seems to be a complete liar, okay? It seems to be a complete liar. But there's one other option, and that is that it's an obedient servant, and that we told it to lie to us. See, that's the option that we haven't seen yet, that we're getting that into focus. When we get that into focus, it changes everything. It changes everything. Because the mind does seem to be lying to us continuously, and it does seem to be an inherent liar. It continuously lies to us. Even when it says that it is an inherent liar, it lies to us. And it will say that. It'll say, no, yeah, I cannot help but lie. I'm just an inherent liar. That's a lie too. But that doesn't mean it's an inherent liar. Because the answer is, we're spirit. We told mind, I want you to lie to me. I want you to play the role of an inherent liar. But mind is just being obedient to us. Now if we say, mind, I want you to not lie to me, then it will stop lying. It won't lie anymore, because it's an obedient servant. So this is the great paradox, the Corinthian liar paradox of saying, the person from Corinth says, all Corinthians are liars. And then someone says, yeah, but you're from Corinth too, so you must be lying. And that means that they're not all liars. But wait a minute. If they're not all liars, you must be telling the truth. So then they all are liars. But wait a minute. See how it goes around and around in circles like that? And this is where we get stuck. We all get stuck on this. And fortunately, the Holy Spirit's been able to show me the resolution to this and share it here, is that mind is a completely obedient servant. We told mind to lie to us. And so that's what mind is doing. Why did we tell mind to lie to us? Or how did this happen? Because we said, mind, we want to be prime creator. We want to be greater than God. And what can mind do except to lie to us about this? And saying, of course, there's a way. Yes, yes, you are greater than God. It's just you haven't yet realized it. So mind has this has told us there's this journey of realization that can take place. And we're on this journey of realization. Now, it can use different terms. It can say we're on a journey of evolution. We're on a journey of evolution of consciousness. We're on a journey towards enlightenment. We're on a journey. All lies, okay? Because we cannot be greater than God. Cannot be greater than God. God is primary. The prime creator is primary, will always be primary. We are created by the prime creator. So this so-called journey of realization, this great adventure that we're told we're going to realize something, this journey is going to result in a realization, becoming real, becoming real. How funny it is for that which already is real to be go on a journey of becoming real, you see, because it's trying to become something that it isn't, something different than what it is. Now this becoming different than what one is actually what we call death. So we're really trying to realize death. That is what the whole journey, this adventure, is to realize death. the evolution of consciousness, the journey to realization, is a journey to try and die. But we can't die because we didn't create what we are. God created what we are. And the ideas of God don't leave the mind of God. And so God created us as eternal life so we can never die. So this whole journey of realization doesn't get anywhere. It has no success to it whatsoever. The fact is that it is a training program more than a journey. Mind lies to us and says it's a journey and puts a frame around it to make it seem like a journey. You see, it's like a movie we're watching on a movie screen, and then around this movie screen is all this elaborate frame around the screen. And when we look at the frame, we think, oh, we're on a journey. We're on a pilgrimage towards realization. We're evolving. All this, it's, you know. But if we look just at the movie itself and not the frame, we see we're not getting anywhere. Nothing is happening. It's a training program, not a journey, a training program. So the frame distracts us from what it actually is. But we need to look at the movie itself and say, oh my gosh, all this is happening is that we are trying to train ourselves how to die. And it's like we go from one exercise piece of exercise equipment to another, but we're in the same gym. The gymnasium, the gym is the same. And everything takes place in this gym. And we're working out in this gym. And we go from one workout to the other. That's all we're doing. Okay, it's not a journey anywhere. It's a training program. This is a different way of looking at it. Vastly better way, because then we can recognize that the Holy Spirit has a training program for us too. To help us drop this effort towards death, which is definitions. It trains us to let go of definitions, let go of this quote-unquote journey, stable state, nothing's being redefined. The Holy Spirit has a training program that deals with the continuity issue, continuity problem. Because we say, what do we do with this gymnasium? What do we do with all this training equipment? We don't want to just have it vanish. Holy Spirit says, don't worry, I can give you a different training program, very different, different goals, but the same equipment, everything can remain basically the same, with some slight changes. There'll be some slight changes. And you can see, once you see it as a training program, then you can also recognize the Holy Spirit has a training program. And then you can change training programs very easily, very easily. Seeing it as it is the key. So we are at the point now where it is becoming much easier to see it as it is. And we're becoming very nervous with the notion that it's a journey. Very nervous indeed. We're saying, uh-oh, it seems to me more like this is we're having exercises imposed upon us. That we're being, this is, I don't like this journey. This whole notion of it being a journey is not working for me. Okay, so very simple. instead of accepting the ego's definition of what's going on, the mind's lie about what's going on. Remember, we told the mind to lie to us. So when it says this is a journey, that's a lie. The Holy Spirit says this is a training program. It's not a journey. So we're using the Holy Spirit's definitions for what is the mind is presenting to us. The movie that the mind is presenting to us, we let the Holy Spirit define it for us. Okay, that's right use of definition. The Holy Spirit will tell the truth about it. Because we told the mind to lie to us and tell us there's a way to be prime, greater than God. God created the Holy Spirit and told the Holy Spirit to tell the truth to us that there is no way to be greater than God. Now see, there's so... the mind is lying to us. The Holy Spirit is telling the truth to us. So the Holy Spirit can use definitions. But it has right use. It uses definitions to enable us to let go of definitions. So the first step is to recognize that existence is a training program designed to train us how to die to what we are. Because in order to be greater than God, we have to change what we are. So that means we have to change what is. And everything in reality is what is. And it's indivisible whole. So if we want to try and change what is, we're really desiring for annihilation to take place, for death to take place. So we're trying to, the mind says, in order to be greater than the God, we have to die to what we are. What we are has to vanish. And then out of that vanishing, the mind tells us, we will be resurrected, reborn as prime creator, as something different, as something greater than God. This is all a complete lie. You know, there's no possibility of that ever happening. It's impossible for us to die. There is no such thing as death. But what the mind is doing is making definitions and then redefining these definitions. This is a tree, but now, 10 years from now, this is a dead tree. You see, it's no longer what I defined it as previously. So the Holy Spirit tells us the truth about this training program. We're trying to learn how to die. This is essential. We're trying to learn how to die. And mind tells us we're on a journey towards realization. It doesn't tell us we're trying to learn how to die. It says we're on a journey towards self-realization. We're on a journey of evolving consciousness. We're on this great journey back to Godhead. If we're going back to Godhead, why did we journey away from Godhead, so to speak? So the mind keeps telling us whatever we want to hear, whatever lie we want to hear about this great journey we're on, this great adventure, this great realization. We're on a journey towards enlightenment, all this stuff. Holy Spirit says, no, 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 no. That's not true. It's a lie. You have only been engaged in a training program, and you're completely habituated to a training program. Therefore, for the sake of continuity, the Holy Spirit will give us a different training program. We'll keep the training aspect of it. We'll keep the training aspect of it. We'll keep what is familiar to us, the training aspects of it. Holy Spirit has a different training program, and it will explain, you know, what this is. It's very simple. Other videos have explained it at great length. What I'm pointing out here is that the mind tells us that it's a complete liar. And that is a lie. It's not a complete liar. So how do you fix this paradox? It seems like we're trapped in this paradox. We're not. The mind is an obedient servant, and we told the mind to lie. This resolves the Corinthian paradox, which has been just bullying us all this time, bullying us. Because we don't want to admit we told the mind to lie to us. Because we want to admit, we want to say that we can become prime creator. So we want to say that no, the mind knows a way. There has to be a way. So it's not lying to us. We didn't tell the mind to lie to us. We told the mind to tell us the truth, that there is a way to be prime creator. So it's our own desire that blinds us. It's our own desire to be prime creator that blinds us to this dynamic. And then we're just tormented by this. There's this deep down, we feel there's this confusion, and we don't understand where it's coming from. But it's very simple. We told the mind, make us prime creator, make us greater than God. What can the mind do then except to lie to us? It has to lie to us because there is no way. But we told the mind, show us the way. And so mind has to lie to us. Mind says, of course there's a way, boss. I know, there's a way. God's been hiding it from you. And you say, yeah. That's true. I know that's true. And then mind, you know, just keeps lying. All it can do is lie to us. With this idea that we gave mind, all it can do is lie to us. But that doesn't mean that the mind is in a liar, inherent liar, a created liar. The bug gets so hot that the bugs are out. It just means that we gave this mind a lot. Go away, bug. We told the mind, this is the idea we want to experience. We want to be greater than God. But we're not stuck with that idea. We can choose the idea we don't want to be greater than God. We want to be what we are. And so the Holy Spirit's training program trains us to gradually feel comfortable about setting down definitions, about setting down this idea, this notion that we need definitions of what we are. Because to define what we are is to try to die to what we are. Because whatever is defined can be redefined. Right? So if we want to change what we are, first we have to begin to define what we are, so that then we can then change those definitions and believe that we're dying to what we are. So we're surrounded by definitions, projecting all these definitions on everything, so that we live in a world of total death, it seems like, because everything is being redefined ceaselessly. The dance of energy, the play of energy, is the play of redefinition. Reality is not based on energy, it's based on essence. Nothing's being redefined in reality. Everything is overflowing, but it's not being redefined. It's not the same. Everything is expanding in creation and joy, but it's what is just adding to what is. It's not redefining what is. The isness is not being redefined. Whereas in existence, in this training program, we feel as if the isness is constantly being redefined. What is constantly being redefined. But all we're reacting to is definitions. And definitions are not what is, because what is cannot be defined, because it's endless. Isness is endlessness. There is no way to define it. Life cannot be defined. So we are at the pivotal point in mind's story, but it's really a training program. Okay, so let's stop saying story. It's a training program that's camouflaging itself as a story, as a journey, etc., etc. It's no different than getting on an exercise bike and thinking that you're getting somewhere. We're not getting anywhere, because we're not teaching ourselves how to die. will follow the storyline about all these things dying, being redefined. And that thinking that if we just follow this trail of redefinition, that we will find the treasure at the end of the rainbow. And we now know that's not true at all. The trail just continues on and on and on and on and on. You never get to the end of the rainbow. Because we keep saying, well, I haven't died yet. I haven't died yet. I haven't, all these redefinitions, and yet I'm still the same. What's going on? You see, it's always that way. There's always something that's aware of the redefinitions. That awareness hasn't changed, doesn't change. Same awareness. So we're at the point now where redefinitions will take on a very, very, very strong, the path will seem to be very compelling for those who are eager to find their death, find realization. And so we have to decide which training program do we want to go with. Shall we make a change in training programs is the question. And I say certainly yes, absolutely. And there's a way to explain it that makes it very simple. Instead of trying to deal with all these redefinitions, you don't deal with all the redefinitions. You just say, look, change training programs. Steady state. We're going into what's called steady state. So the first step in the Holy Spirit's training program is to experience what's called steady state. That's the first step. So what I want to do is to take all the mysticism out of the whole situation. Take all the awe out of it. Don't awe yourself. So in other words, this quote-unquote natural state, enlightenment, all this stuff that people talk about, that's just the first step in the Holy Spirit's training program. That's just a steady state. So when you experience a steady state, you don't say, oh my God, I'm enlightened. I've reached nirvana. I mean, it's like, well, it's nirvana. Sure, so I'm in nirvana. Well, that's just the first step. That just means that you've decided to accept the Holy Spirit's training program. So that's just the very first result. That's what you get as a beginning to that, is a steady state. Steady state. All these redefinitions are not affecting you, how you feel. How you feel is a steady, cohesive oneness, a state of oneness, steady state. But that's just the first step. So you don't need to be overawed by what has happened when you experience the steady state. We're accustomed, another lie of mine, is to tell us, hey, that's it. You've done it. Wow, you're self-realized, blah, blah, blah. No, that's not true at all. And so we have this idea that this is the end. It's not the end. It's just the beginning of the Holy Spirit's training program. So when we see it this way, it's very humbling, right? Because it's like, oh my gosh, I want to be enlightened and everyone in the world to think I'm it. I'm enlightened. I'm the big cheese. No, that's not true at all. It's only the beginning. It's only the beginning. It just means that you've decided to step onto the whole, decided to choose the Holy Spirit's training program. That's all it means. On from there, you end up going, dwelling in the death-free realm. Okay. And you... There's a whole training program to go beyond all definitions. All definition. Drop all definition. Drop the whole universe. The universe of endless, infinite definitions. Drop all definitions permanently. And experience reality actually as it is. That's a whole training program. We're not even close to that. Just experiencing the steady state. We're not even close to the goal of that. We're just starting out on a training program, that's all. So paradoxically, by listening to this and hearing this and accepting it, it makes it infinitely easier to get into this steady state. If you stop thinking that it's some, it means you're the big poobah, you know, you're now the guru, you're the master, you're the enlightened, all this stuff. No, not at all. Not at all. You're just a neophyte, and yet you are in a steady state. And so to the world, to the ego says, "Oh my God, this is incredible! You know, you somehow reached the goal of self-realization, or somehow you found death or something." No, none of that, none of that nonsense. I'm just a beginner in the Holy Spirit's training program. Is all. So this takes the pressure off of you. You see what I'm saying? That's all important. Is that's what I've worked towards in this life. Take the pressure off of us. Take the pressure off of us. The mind has been lying to us about all spirituality. Is a pack of lies by the mind. It puts too much pressure on us. Way too much pressure. The idea that somehow you're in steady state, that now you can explain to everybody how they can be self-realized and reach their goals, and you can solve them, orchestrate the solution to the problems of the world. Utter nonsense, utter nonsense. All you are is you're just a neophyte accepting the Holy Spirit's training program. That's all that it means. Now you can tell others that this, and say, I feel fine, it's a steady state, that's great. That's all that it means. You can explain to them the simplicity of just change training programs, that's all. Take all the mysticism out. But the problem is, everybody that comes to you has all this stuff from the mind, all these lies about the spiritual path, about mysticism, esotericism, philosophy, you know, just infinite a number of lies, and they're all wanting you to validate their lies. And they're telling you, you're great, we want to worship you, you're God, you're the guru. It's utter nonsense. See, they want to have their all this validated, which is the mind just keeping them in a confused state, so they continue on with the mind's training program of how to die, thinking that it's something else, that they're pursuing self-realization, pursuing oneness with God, all this stuff. And they'll say, "Oh my God, you're one with God." No. I'm just in what's called the steady state, which is just the beginning. It's just a sign, an effect of choosing the Holy Spirit's training program. But the training program will go on, you know, for quite a bit, really, until it's complete. So that's all. That's all that it is. You see, the mind wants us to not take the Holy Spirit's training program. So it wants to try to elevate us into some ultimate status, a guru status, so we can be worshipped and not find out about the Holy Spirit's training program. What the mind does is comes to you and says, "Look, if you get into this steady state, I will tell everyone that you're the ultimate, and they'll all worship you. As long as you don't tell anybody about this Holy Spirit's training program," it tries to make a deal with you like that. It says, if you claim you're the ultimate, the steady state means you are the ultimate, you are God, you're the greatest guru there ever was, then I'll send everybody to you and they'll all worship you. But just don't tell them that it's only just the beginning of the Holy Spirit's training program. Don't tell them that, you see, because I don't want that. So the mind tries to convince you that this is how you can help others. It's not true. That's why you get these aggrandized gurus who tell you that they're the greatest. No, they just had a a glimpse of the steady state, and then they made a deal with the mind because they said, hey, they could be worshipped as God. And the mind will tell everybody that they're God, which is another lie. And then they'll give them all this spiritual rhetoric about justifying this lie. You know? That happens a lot. It happens quite a bit here. And then they're not in the steady state anymore. And then they have to lie about why. And then they claim, well, they're not in the steady state because they need to help others work through their karma and helping others, and they're engaging in a play, some crazy wisdom play with others. That's why they're not in the steady state, and they're sacrificing their steady state for the good of their devotees and all this stuff. And then in payment for that, they want the devotees to worship them as God, etc., etc. This is, again, just a pack of lies of the mind, just a pack of lies. So when you get close to the steady state, or when you're trying to get there, you're trying to accept the Holy Spirit's training program, the mind is constantly telling you, no, just you can be worshipped as God. Why do you need to go be this lowly neophyte in the Holy Spirit's training program? The mind says, I can get everybody to worship you as God. Well, we've seen how that turns out, haven't we? The one being worshipped is miserable. And those that worship that one end up being miserable too. Big waste of time. But that is a, you know, that's a trap. That's a trap. So that's what we struggle with. We say, huh, maybe I can help people more by being this great guru or something. No, you cannot. You cannot. You can help people more by showing them that you're just a beginner in the Holy Spirit's training program. But again, let me emphasize this, that a beginner, an absolute neophyte in the Holy Spirit's training program is far greater than the very greatest in the training program of trying to die. All right? So it will seem, everyone will say, my gosh, you're greater than anybody here in the world. You're the greatest. Well, like again, even a rank beginner in the Holy Spirit's training program is greater than the very greatest in the ego, quote-unquote, ego's training program, which is training program of how to die. But that doesn't mean that you are God, or, you know, it doesn't mean that you are super advanced in the Holy Spirit's training program. It doesn't mean anything like that at all. So you can see the trouble, you know, the temptation is to think that you're something really great. No. It's the Holy Spirit's training program that's great. It's the greatness of the Holy Spirit that is being reflected in this steady state. And people say, wow, that's incredible. You know, if I could only have some of that steady state, I could really advance along my training program just great, you see, and that's the delusion. So it's very difficult for those who are loyal to the mind's lies, which is loyal to their own desire to be prime creator. They cannot understand it. They twist it and misconstrue. They misconstrue it. But it's not impossible to unravel all this. I've been able to do it up to this point. See, the mind is desperate. The mind says, I just need some guru to reassure everybody that this training program is going to work for them. So I just want to hold somebody up and say, look, you see, it worked for them. Look, they reached God status. They're now God. You know, and like that. So there are a few knuckleheads along the way who like to play that role for a little while, but it's doubtful that they will continue on with that, they don't enjoy it very much. After a while, it gets pretty rancid for them. And they say, whoa, I don't want to do that again. But the mind is always searching for someone, saying, hey, who's going to play the role of God here and show everybody, you see, this training program can work for you. See, the mind is always desperate for that. So when you show a willingness to go to the steady state, mind tries to cut a deal with you and say, hey, why don't you just claim that this is realization, that you've reached Godhead, you know, you're God now, and then I can use you to keep everyone motivated on this training program, and you can play the role of God, and won't that be fun? You know, you have all these people worshiping you, you know, and so the mind tries to convince you of this. And that's a great difficulty on the path, because it's very confusing. It's just like, wow. Yeah, and mind says, don't you want to help everybody? If you do that, you'll help everybody. You'll help everybody realize God. Of course, what the mind doesn't say is what its training program is trying to help spirit become greater than God. You see? That is, so what mind's really saying is, hey, you're going to help everybody become greater than God, which is impossible. So how can you help anyone accomplish the impossible? How can you help anyone accomplish the impossible? It's not possible. So, when the mind feels that its training program is faltering, it brings in someone who plays that role of God in the world, and the mind can say, look, you see, this whole training program is possible, it can work, you can become God. And then people say, okay, it does work, oh, that's okay, that confirms my what I want, yeah, it's great. And then what happens is then they lose their will to their humility to accept the Holy Spirit's training program, and then they refocus on the mind's training program, and then they end up going forward blindly and stumbling, as what's happened in the world now. As you look at the world now, that's a result of a collective loss of will in the world. Okay. I can talk about this historically. We have hindsight now, knowing what happened. What happened, we have to be careful in this, but I'll try to say what happened, is there was an enormous buildup of willingness to switch over to the Holy Spirit's training program. Because of the grace of God, brought in some genuine gurus, those who were genuinely actually finished with the Holy Spirit's training program. Or in one case, one that had never chosen to try and be prime creator in the first place, who had never ever strayed into this idea of wanting to be greater than God. And there was a buildup on this planet of a realization, hey, we can accept the Holy Spirit's training program. We can accept the steady state and humbly realize that's the beginning of it. And we can do this. So the mind felt tremendously threatened by this. Tremendously, it felt that its training program was about to be abandoned. And it felt that, you know, the pride, spirit's pride, was telling mind, you're about to fail. And mind says, oh, no, I can't fail, you'll never trust me again, which is another lie. See, this is circular lies here is the problem. And so mind brought forth a really big, a whopper of a lie in the world, several of them, and the mind brought forth these super gurus who claimed that they were God. Okay, and the mind then used that to convince the world that its program can work, you see. And then people then let go of their true humility and repentance and re-embrace the minds, jumped into the abyss. And we that is why we're at where we're at right now. So, in other words, the mind played its trump card. Now, it's fortunate for me that the Holy Spirit played its trump card in my case. And I was able to battle through that and see through it, but it was extremely difficult. But successful. The mind, even when the mind plays its ultimate trump card, the Holy Spirit can still enable us to work through that and resolve it and see it for what it is. Now, you know, I'm referring to several gurus who claim that they were God, that they were the ultimate, etc. Those are the ones that the ego, the mind, brought into this world to keep us loyal to its training program, making us believe that, yeah, we can become God like that. We don't need to change this. It can work. This can work. And then, of course, then they were pushed out of the way, and we're now, lost at sea in this incredible, terrible situation now in the world. It is. I mean, if you really see that the mind's story, this training program, it's really a training program, is getting really, really scary and nasty. It is. There's no question about it. That the apparatus now that is in place is a persecutory apparatus. It is really, to tell you, to be more exact, we have an inquisitional apparatus in place in the world right now. We are literally entering into a time of inquisition. And the grand inquisitors are on the stage, or more are coming to the front. The grand inquisitors, those who are in charge of the Inquisition, are coming to the front now. And it's about to get very severe. And we're saying, oh my gosh, what do I do? Well, the door is not closed for us. Because at least in one instance here, the mind's trump card has been seen through. And the situation has been resolved and seen as it is. So that shows you it is absolutely possible. We're not stuck in some impossible paradox at all. And even when the mind plays its ultimate trump cards, it still, the Holy Spirit just easily laughs at that and brushes aside. It says, no, it's very simple. So, we can step back from the abyss. We do not have to participate in the Inquisition. We don't need to be participants. We can accept the steady state. Yes, we're freshmen. We're neophytes. That's fine. Because again, the steady state is greater than anything in existence. Okay. It is what's called the peace beyond understanding, the steady state. But again, that's just the beginning for us. It's just the beginning. And we can abide in that realization, happiness. I know, it's just the beginning. Instead of labeling this, quote unquote, that means I'm God, or I'm the ultimate, or said, no, it's just the beginning. So we're at a most great time right now. A most great time. So we can dispense with all the spiritual talk, and we can simply boil it all down to saying, I am just a complete rank, complete beginner on the lowest rung of the Holy Spirit's training program. That's all we need to say. And this steady state is just the very lowest rung of the Holy Spirit's training program. And leave it at that. And that takes the air out of the mind's balloon. You know, it can't inflate us. You know, egoic inflation, spiritual inflation, which it tries to do to prop up its impossible training program. And then simply say, join me in the bottom rung here of the Holy Spirit's training program. Welcome, welcome, come on in. Come on in, there's plenty of room here. Let's all do this, we can do this all together if we like. Very lowest rung, we're all just on the very, all we're trying to do right now in this world is get on the very bottom rung of the Holy Spirit's training program. That's it. Nothing else other than that. Nothing else other than that. That's all that we're called to do. And then call others to that too. That's all. That's the only goal there is right at this point. Because then the subsequent rungs at some point rather soon is ascension to the death-free realm. The death-free realm where the training really then picks up steam. But in this world, all we need is the steady state. So what is the steady state? It's simply the state where all the redefinitions that are taking place doesn't redefine the steady state. There's no redefinition taking place at all with the steady state. And so you're in this people call it bliss or whatever you want, peace of mind, bliss. It's just steady state, no redefinition taking place. Again, bottom rung. You call it nirva kalpa, samadhi, you know, highest nirvana. Also, you don't need any of that stuff. All this, all these categories of all these samadhis and nirvanas and all these kinds of things. We don't need any of that. We don't need any of that. All we need to say is, no, I'm on the bottom rung of the Holy Spirit's training program. That's it. Because open-eyed samadhi, supposedly the highest state, is really this beginning state. In other words, everything you see or whatever you do, your steady state. There's no redefinition taking place in how you feel. There's a steady state. This is just the bottom rung. But here people will think, oh, you're the ultimate or something. No. So just get on this bottom rung, steady state. Last night in dreams, I was trying to decide whether to choose the steady state or not. And there was just I said, that's pretty simple. Yeah, I can do that. There was just a little bit of turbulence here and there, that kind of thing. What's important, again, is because we do not have the proper institutional support to put the steady state into context. It's very important now that we hear this message that it's simply the bottom rung. That's all we're going to claim, period. Nobody needs to claim that they're some great teacher, great master, that they're enlightened, self-realized, any of this stuff. Drop all that. Drop it. It's too dangerous at this point. Too dangerous. You're going to get swept away if you make those claims. Just say, bottom rung, absolute neophyte, rank beginner. I'm just the rankest beginner. So I don't have anything to offer. I'm just, except I can just tell you the steady state is a steady state, period. But I'm just a rank beginner. But you can be a rank beginner too. Welcome. You can sit beside me as a rank beginner. There's no problem. See, that is the place of safety right now. Now, of course, there have been programs in this world, very advanced, great, truly realized gurus that have helped bring, help those go up the rung ladder, so to speak. But at this point in time in history, I'm telling you, forget all that. Forget about all of that. That is dangerous to you now. They'll drop everything except say, I'm just a rank beginner. Just wet behind the ears, And not trying to be anything other than that at this point. As far as in the world now, my only goal is just to be this rank beginner, just to accept this steady state. That's it. Not aiming for anything higher than that, just a steady state at this point. See? And this is your safety. When you can accept this humility, you will find the burdens of the world lifting off your shoulders. You will feel that. The reason why I'm feeling better and better and better about myself is because of this. All these burdens that were placed on my shoulders are now being lifted off. You say, I'm the very lowest. On the Holy Spirit's training program. I haven't gotten anywhere. I'm just at the start line, stretching. I'm just stretching. Limbering up at the start line. I'm not even started, but I've been accepted. So this is just like, you might say, well, I've been accepted into the Holy Spirit's training program, but I haven't, gone anywhere with it yet. But I've been accepted. So in other words, I have the certificate of acceptance, which is a steady state. A steady state is just like a certificate of acceptance that you've chosen the Holy Spirit's program and been accepted into the Holy Spirit's training program. So you have the certificate, and that's the steady state. Steady state is just a certificate, like. So the safety at this time, success and safety depends on humility and saying, drop all esoteric, spiritual talk, all that stuff, drop it, all of it, virtually all of it, for the purposes of conversation. We'll try to simplify it all to just simply steady state, that's it. Steady state, that's all. No love, light, da 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 da. Of course, we do have the ascension to the death-free realm, but more importantly, right now, just a steady state, rank beginner, lowest, from the lowest rank, lowest rank, very lowest rank. I cannot make any claims to anything except the lowest rank. That's it. The only claim I have is lowest rank, very lowest rank. And of course, the mind will say, oh, but if you claim higher rank, so many people want to come see you because I'll claim that you have this high rank, and people get to associate with something really close to God, and then I can tell them that, no, forget it. That doesn't help anyone. It doesn't help you at all. It'll cause you severe problems and not help anybody. Lowest rank. So, see, I say, I'm the lowest ranking in the Holy Spirit's training program. And I'll share this low rank with everybody here too. And don't fall for this nonsense. Another trick is to say, well, there is no rank. Yeah, there is no rank, so you are the ultimate. That's not true. That is not true. That's another trick the mind uses, is to say, well, there is no I, meaning there is no rank. That's not true. If that's the same way of saying there is no training program, that the steady state is it. There isn't anything else. That's not true. Not true at all. So this whole, there's another trick on the mind. It's mind going the back door the other way, saying, oh, there is no I, there is no you, there is no self. So you are the ultimate rank because you don't have any rank. That is not true at all. No, I'm a complete low freshman, lowest rank. And there's definitely many steps on the Holy Spirit's training program. Absolutely. So the mind is very tricky. Mind is very tricky in the way it does. So insist, know that there are ranks and you're in the lowest rank. Insist on it. Because the mind will either try to aggrandize you or the opposite and claim that you're the ultimate because there are no ranks. And since you're the ultimate, you should be worshipped here. And people should come to say that you're the ultimate. And again, the mind's goal is to say that there is no Holy Spirit and there is no Holy Spirit training program. That's its goal. That's the only way it can keep its lies going, which, again, it's only lying as an obedient servant because our pride, spiritual pride, we want to be prime creator. So our desire keeps the mind telling us lies. And the only way that mind can keep us spellbound, which is we want to be spellbound, the only way it can is to deny that there's a Holy Spirit training program. It's the only way. Now, it tries to offer all these substitute training programs and claim that the steady state is the highest realization, where in fact it's the lowest rank on the Holy Spirit's training program. See? So that's it. It tries to divert us away from the Holy Spirit's training program. So if you're in steady state, the mind will say, oh my God, you've succeeded in my training program. You're the ultimate. You say, No. If only I'm on the lowest rank in the Holy Spirit's training program. Mind, your training program is bogus. Totally bogus. It's a lie. It's a lie. Because as soon as you accept the mind saying that you reach the highest rank in this training program, you lose it. You lose the steady state. And you then work towards aggrandizement, self-aggrandizement. Surrounded by a frame of spiritual rhetoric, of course. You'll have all the pictures of all the gurus in history around you, you know, as you work towards self-aggrandizement. That the mind, you know, does that. So, lowest ranks, all right? Insist there are ranks. There is an I, there is a self. In other words, there is a rank. When the mind says no self, no I, none of this, it's saying there's no Holy Spirit training program. That's a lie. The idea that everything just here in this world as it is, all this, everything's just happening, etc., 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 etc. That's not the Holy Spirit's training program. Because here, the Holy Spirit does have a training program that goes beyond what we can conceptualize or even speak about. This steady state is the lowest rank, and yet it's being taught in this world as the highest of as realization. You know, all these teachers I see in the world, so many, not all, but many, 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 who are supposedly enlightened, have reached this natural state. They're enlightened. And there is no I, there is no self, there is no me. That's the lowest rank. That's just the first step, as it were. But they're putting it into the wrong context, so that they don't even abide in it truly themselves. So they don't talk about the Holy Spirit's training program. They say, "Oh, I realized that there's no one experiencing anything. There's just all this is just spontaneously happening, and that's all there is." You know, stuff like that. So steady state is, again, the lowest rank. Nothing to brag about. If someone asks you, people will come and say, "Why, what's going on? It's incredible." Nothing to brag about. I just changed training programs. I haven't accomplished anything yet. You see, it takes the wind out of the sails of the mind and all its aggrandizement. And of course, all these miracles will take place around you, and people will say, "Oh, I'm being healed, blah, blah, blah." That's just the mind trying to aggrandize you, you know, trying to say, "Hey, aggrandize yourself. There's all these, everybody's getting healed," or something. "No, I haven't accomplished anything. All I've done is choose the Holy Spirit's training program, but I haven't accomplished anything in that program yet at all." So, this is vastly helpful. Just imagine the entire weight of all those expectations taken off your shoulders. And you feel you can breathe. You can finally breathe again. The spiritual path feels like you can't breathe. You know, under so much pressure, you know, to be great. No, take the pressure off. You're under no pressure to be great at all here. It's so incredible. We're so frantic. We need to help the world. We need to become great. No, the way to help the world is to take all the pressure off of yourself from being great and to accept the lowest status in the Holy Spirit's training program, and then to show others that they can do that too, and that's okay. It's not like you become distraught because you have the lowest status. No, you're not just, the world doesn't, can't even touch you anymore. Can't affect you at all. So you're happy to have the lowest status because you're starting. At least you're starting. You're ready to start. Let's say you're ready to start. But there's no pressure, you know, to start. You're ready to start. You're not being hurried or pushed. All the redefinitions of the world dance around you, but you're not affected by them. How you feel is not affected by them. Steady state, you're in steady state. Bliss, you're in bliss. Steady state, you could call it bliss. Nothing's being redefined. Your body, mind, how you feel is not being redefined at all. Again, this is the lowest, right? Just ready to begin the training program. Just ready to begin. That's all. And that's all you have to claim. And I'm just ready to begin is all I am. I'm just ready to begin. See, okay? So many people think that you're like completely self-realized and you're the greatest. And they said, "No, I'm just ready to begin. That's all I am. I'm just ready to begin a training program. That's it." And then some will catch this breeze. And I'll say, whoa, wait a minute. This might help be helpful for me. This might enable me to get rid of this massive demands of mind that's put on me of a spiritual path and all this stuff. It's just been killing me. It's just terrible. I say, hey, wait a minute. Maybe there's a way to get out of that. I'm just ready to begin. That's all. Just feel how absolutely freeing that is, how immensely freeing that is. Whereas you just say, no, all I'm claiming is I'm just ready to begin the Holy Spirit's training program. And I'm just abiding in this readiness to begin. That's it. Nothing more than that. Nothing more than that. And I'm, you know, blissful that you begin. It's very blissful. That's all, but that's all you can need to claim. All you need to claim is I'm just ready to begin. Lowest rank, meaning I'm ready to begin the Holy Spirit's training program. If when we can utilize this, cancels out all the troubles right there. And there's a ton of troubles right now in the world. The mind has been ferocious in its lies. The mind has brought all its aces, everything up out of its sleeve, out of its boot, thrown the joker in the deck, everything to turn us away from the Holy Spirit's training program. Aggrandize, get into this aggrandize, spiritually aggrandized condition by bringing some very spiritually aggrandized actors on the stage. And that has led us into this inquisition. Make no mistake, the mind is about ready to teach us how to die as it thinks it has the answer. It can teach us how to die. So of course it's going to. The Inquisition is going to take place. And by dying, I don't just mean physical death. No, the training program of the mind is at all these various quote-unquote levels, all these definitions. Culture, society, world, job, reputation. Money, friends, everything, the whole kit and caboodle is being redefined, and the Inquisition deals with all of that, you know, fairness, justice, everything. You will feel as if you're losing everything. Everything is being redefined. Or you can choose to be ready to begin the Holy Spirit's training program, so none of this bothers you in the slightest bit. One or the other, it's one or the other. So we're letting go of all the self-aggrandizement that the ego, the mind, lied to us about. Mind says, oh, I can make you God right now. Why do you need to be the lowest rung, just ready to begin a training program? He says, oh, you're tired of training programs. I can make you God right now. No, it can't. All it does is throws you into the jaws of the Inquisition. And the Iron Maiden is brought out once again, as it is most definitely being brought out. We're all going to be put in an Iron Maiden that's going to be slowly closed on us. That's the mind's training program. So again, we are disengaging from the mind's self-aggrandizement. It's supposed to be over 100 today. It feels okay here right now, but we'll see what it's like at 3 o'clock. Just ready to begin. Have haven't even begun yet, just ready to begin. I've now been confirmed as ready to begin, and this steady state is simply a confirmation that I'm ready to begin, but I'm not beginning yet. The beginning takes place in the death-free realm. At least that's how I see it at this time. That seems what's most likely. Because the way that the world is going now, it's kaput. You know, the mind is going to do its dance here. Inquisitional dance on all levels. And we were warned about this ahead of time. This is the end times. This is the end of the cycle. This is when redefinition becomes fast and furious. And so this is an opportune time to ascend to the death-free realm where the Holy Spirit's training program is easy. Very safe, the safe way, as it were. But until that happens, all we need to say is we are simply ready to begin the training program. Let us make no claims for advancement in the training program. We're just ready to begin. Okay, this takes the pressure off of you. Takes the pressure off of us. Doesn't give the mind much to grab a hold of as far as self-aggrandizement goes. So this is the great good news, this has been able to be shared here, and right in the nick of time. Like I said, just around June 30th, we are going to get a boost, and this is certainly a big boost. To be able to see this, of where do we position ourselves, is an enormous boost, Now, even if there was a truly one who has gone beyond all definitions, comes into the world, our position still is only to abide in this. I'm ready to begin. I'm not claiming any more advancement than that at this point. That's it. And I'm just abiding in that. And I'm calling everyone else to abide in that also. We're not trying to make great advancements. We're not trying to glorify the guru or anything. We're just saying, let us accept readiness to begin, and that's it. That's it. Simplifies the entire thing. So the only state you're trying to reach is readiness to begin. That's it at this point. Nothing more than that. So for this, if a truly realized guru one's gone beyond all definitions is here, that still is your only goal, is to readiness to begin. That's it. No other goal. Makes it incredibly easy, doesn't it? Wonderfully easy. Fabulous. All right. This is just tremendous. I feel able to breathe. My gosh. Burdens are being released. You know, the pressure is coming off. Just readiness to begin. Steady state. That's it. Okay. Who knows what's going to happen next? I mean, the videos may become like, I don't know what's going to happen, really. This is just like, no idea of what could happen next. That's okay. All I'm aiming for is readiness to begin. Steady state, readiness to begin. So, come what may. That's the only goal. that I'm accepting it right now. That's it. The only goal here, just that, just that, just abide in that. So all these dynamics are kind of working themselves out, being released. All this other stuff that was trying to use me for its goals is now being released because I've decided what my goal is. So I don't need all this other dynamics, you see. All the mind's training that was trying to play with, get me to do its play is now being released, not necessary. Don't really need to follow the story of the release. Just, you know, let it dissipate, like putting a pan of water in the sun. Let it just evaporate. You don't need to follow the story of the evaporation so much, or you can if you want to. But either way, it doesn't matter. Just So I'm getting ready to go back to the world now. And so there's a little bit of nervousness because I've been in a very different place in this video, actually, than previously ever. So I'm thinking like, well, how do I go back to the world at this point? So there's a little bit of nervousness, actually. How do I talk with others at this point? I don't know. We'll find out. It's just you know, habit. Just go on habit. Okay. June 29th, and this information is being shared. I'll try to get this up by the 30th here. Probably we'll be up there by the 30th, if not before. Okay, this is a big boost for sure. This video has been, I certainly feel it has been for me. All right. Look, we leave it at that.